5 years later, I had to play Vladimir Kramnik for another challenge, for the World Championship match in London. And it was a great year for me. From 99 to the first half of 2000, I had probably the best winning streak in my career, maybe the best in the history of chess. I had the highest rating ever. I won number of tournaments, eventually all tournaments I played, and the quality of chess was superb. It just was great ideas, you know, splash here and there, in the openings, in the middle game, in the end game. And so I believed, as everybody said, I was unbeatable. It doesn't mean that I stopped working. I worked really hard. I came back with new ideas. I wanted to surprise Kramnik, and I believed I had enough strength to win. But he was a good pupil of Botvinnik, and he was a good pupil of Garry Kasparov. He looked at all the games, and he found that even, you know, on this burning sun, there were some spots. So there were certain positions where I didn't feel very comfortable, certain moments where I slipped, where I was hesitant, where, you know, you could actually find out that Kasparov's game was not very consistent. So he designed a strategy, a great strategy to drag me from the territories where I felt most comfortable into the territories where I felt shaky. So it's like, you know, two different, you know, types of game, like in tennis. Somebody has a huge serve and then rushes to the net, and someone is playing from the back line, just waiting for mistakes and then hitting hard. Kramnik played from the back line. But he also was very smart to know exactly where I could make mistake and on what turf he could prove that Kasparov was not unbeatable. The match was a disaster for me. In 15 games, I couldn't win a single one and lost two. And I lost the match to Kramnik. I was out-prepared.